Hey guys, welcome back to Writer's Reality. My name is Suneet Malhotra and today I am at the beautiful city of Kasol. Now Kasol is actually a small town which is part of the Kullu district in Himachal. Kasol is also called the mini Israel of India. That's because you can actually find a lot of Israelis. They say they find this place very comfortable for them. Kasol itself hosts a lot of places where they offer Israeli food. The natives here know Israeli as one of the key language. It comes under Parvati Valley, and the Parvati River itself flows through Kasol. Other attractions of Kasol includes Manikaran, which is a Gurudwara, which is about 5 kilometers from Kasol. Other nearby attraction from Kasol includes a place called Khir Ganga. To reach Khir Ganga, about 18-20 kilometers from Kasol is a place called Tosh, where you can reach, either take a local bus or you can go on a car or by bike, and then you have to park your vehicle there, and there's a trek which goes through the jungle. It's a beautiful one. It's about 10 kilometers of trek, and it is not considered to be the very easy one, but then it's a moderate trek. So today in the morning we decided to explore Kasol before actually moving on to Khir Ganga trek. And now that I'm done with it, me and my folks will be going to Khir Ganga and let's see how it turns out to be. So finally, we guys have reached a point called Kalga, where we're supposed to leave our bike. So we've done that, and we are headed to Khir Ganga. It's supposed to be 12-13 kilometers of trek, and it's 1:30 in the afternoon. As usual, we're late, but that's okay. So let's see how it goes. In the middle of the jungle feels crazy right now. I actually feel like I'm part of a Jurassic Park series or something. Let me show you.
आपकी पटके चौहत्तर हो जाएगी।
So we have so far covered about 60 to 65% of the entire journey. Another 90 minutes or so and we should be there. It is all natural, completely. There's nothing man-made, there's no road, off-road or paths. Sometimes you have to figure out where you have to head. This is amazing. If you sit quietly, all you'll hear is the noise of the flowing water stream, the noise of the, and rather the sound of the birds, and that's all. That's how quiet, peaceful this place is. Right, it's not like we are going uphill and downhill while coming back. It's all like a mixture of uphill and downhills and steep and not so steep linear paths while going as well as obviously while coming back. So it's going to take about the same amount of time going as well as coming back from Kiranga. Also, in case you get lost, then you can use wrappers. I'm not proud to say this, but in case you get lost, you can look out for wrappers of biscuits and eatables to figure out which way to walk. Again, I'm not gonna throw my wrapper here, but people have done that and this is the only good thing about it. They're saying Khir Ganga is about 3 kilometers from here, which means that we have covered 9 kilometers so far and we've been really fast. One more hours maybe, but we're gonna take a halt here because we have not exactly taken any breaks except like a 1 minute, 2 minutes, you know, breaks where we sit and, you know, work on our muscles. And but this time it's gonna be a break where we take a good 15-20 minutes break and we eat something, enjoy the place above all, and then move on. Time out now should be around 4:15, so it's not that late. We should be there before sunset. Thank you.
So after trekking for about 4.5 hours, we have finally reached Khir Ganga. It was a bit hectic, but not that difficult. Some of the points that I've learned is one should carry light and one should carry enough warm clothes, because the temperature during the night goes around 4 to 5 degrees, which is too cold. The only way to stay here is our tents and sleeping bags. Yep.